Hi, I'm Joshua.
And I'm Marisa, and welcome to the January edition of PierceTV.
This month we have a special episode highlighting some longer form video work from the digital design and digital film programs. We'll have Steven Crain on, talking about the Health and Wellness Education Center being built on the Fort Steilacoom campus.
We'll start off this month's episode with Michelle Barnes from the Early Childhood Education Program.
The Pierce College Parent Education Program has affiliated cooperative nursery schools in Eatonville, Fort Steilacoom, Midland, Sumner, Oregon, and here on the South Hill. Our program is you earn parent education credits through Pierce College, and the parents in the program work in the nursery school 2 to 3 times a month, working as assistant teachers with the children's teacher. We have a play-based curriculum. Children learn through experiential process. That means they learn through experience, they play. We try to set up real life experience for them. The children have a lot of interaction with their parents and with the other parents in the classroom. They interact with the children's teacher. The parents have a chance to interact with other parents, with children, with the teacher, with myself, the parent educator. We have parenting classes once a month where we sit down and we discuss child development, discipline, potty training, self-esteem, sibling issues, any kind of thing the parents are interested in talking about with their families. It's more of a discussion format, though there is some lecture part. We try to make sure they have a good grounding in child development and educational theory. The children in the classroom are ages 1 to 5, and they come either 2 to 3 times a week, some days with their parents and some days without. The working parent in the classroom gets a lot of experience in the art area, in carpentry, playing with blocks and Play-Doh. It's a really fun thing. The cooperatives are nonprofits run by a parent board, so every parent in the school either serves on a board or serves on a committee. The parent education instructor from Pierce College acts as an advisor to the board, and the children's teachers also serve on the board. The parent cooperative board hires the teachers themselves and really runs the school as a small nonprofit business. The parent educators are here to provide the continuity from year to year. Our teachers all have their degree in early childhood education or are working on that degree and are very involved in the children's process. What we try to provide the children with is real life experiences where they have an opportunity to come into the classroom and use real carpentry tools, build with blocks, play with Play-Doh, always have 2 to 3 art projects out. We have a literacy center. We try to provide a print-rich environment for children so that as they look around the room, they're seeing words and language in use all around the classroom. The cooperatives have been in existence for over 40 years. They've been affiliated with Pierce College, most of them, for 30 years or more. We're interested in starting up some new ones. And we really enjoy, parents leave the co-op with a good sense, they have friends that last for years. I'm actually a former co-op parent who got involved in teaching and have been with the program for 12 years now. So we're always looking for new people to add to our program. We'd like to have our preschools full with a waiting list if we could. So if you're interested, please give us a call. Thanks.
This month we're highlighting some longer 3D films by current and past students.
Up next are 3D films by Rick Pierce and Philip Peterson.
The penguin and his 10 goons are plotting in a back room. Pile, crash, boom, bam, in leaps the Batman, making life safe again for all the Gotham citizens. He's so bitchin', he's so brave, it's back. He's got cool and savoir faire in his cape and collar and his gray underwear. Who is the hero that we like best? Gotta be the Batman, gotta be Adam West. Adam West. I always cheer, I always squeal when he cries out
to the Batmobile.
Commissioner's on the bat phone talking to the duo. Joker has escaped again. How does he stay dry? He never sweats. Which antiperspirant does he like best? Gotta ask the Batman, gotta ask Adam West. Adam West. You can have
You see him at conventions and shopping malls, meeting all his fans. He sure got guts. I combed the TV guide for Batman Fest. Tune it into Batman, tune it into Adam West. Adam West.
You didn't know I was wearing my special Super Thermal B long underwear.
Keep your head down, don't just sleep to the rhythm.
Next up, we'll have Steven Crain on, talking about the Health and Wellness Education Center being built on the Fort Steilacoom campus.
We're out here at the site of the new health science building, and it's an exciting area for Pierce College to watch go up around us, because it's a huge step forward for the health science department. As a coordinator of the health science department, I and a handful of others have been working at having this project come to fruition for probably 4 or 5 years. And it's been a struggle, as all big projects are, but will have a huge impact both for the Health Science Department and for Pierce College. The building behind me, off and then both to the right and the left, will house a new gym, which is actually not completely focused in terms of the health science area, but still is a nice piece to add, both for athletics and just general student activities and so forth. But adjacent to that will be two new floors in a renovated building that was empty and being unused, that will house for the health science department a brand new classroom that will be the second largest classroom on campus and will be able to be used by any department in any class that needs a good sized classroom. But that classroom, while not only being large, is specifically designed for health science types of activities and classes and labs that will really help us expand our curriculum and add a lot of application for students, so they can have hands-on understanding of how to have healthier lives and make healthier lifestyle choices as well. We'll also have a brand new health science lab that will have a variety of increased physiological assessment tools in it. We'll have what's called a hydrostatic weighing tank, where we can accurately measure to the extent of what's considered the gold standard for body composition measurement, measure a person's lean mass and fat percentage with great exactness, so that people can better know their risk for obesity, cardiovascular disease, diabetes, and a variety of things, to help them make, again, good lifestyle choices and avoid a variety of different chronic diseases. The lab will also be able to do a lot of VO2 max assessment, which measures the health of a person's heart and their ability to bring in from the environment around them oxygen, and then during exercise perform at a healthy level. That type of assessment, open circuit indirect calorimetry, is generally only available at really large community colleges. In fact, very few community colleges in the country will have that technology, and we'll be able to have that here in our lab. It will rival the type of exercise physiology lab that probably UW and other four-year major universities has. And because of that technology and the lab that will be unique to the health science department that will be here in this building, we'll be able to build an entirely new health science department and add at least another 6 or 7 classes specifically designed to train people to make, again, healthy lifestyle choices, as well as provide a new health technician or health fitness type of personal trainer program that will be better than any other community college, and in fact the rival of most of the very best nationally ranked programs, so that people can go out and get jobs in the health industry without getting a master's or a PhD, and move right into really advanced personal training types of things that has a science background to it, instead of just a more shallow a fitness component. They'll have the fitness component through this program, but also an extensive exercise physiology program as well, which we're really excited about. And this isn't simply a function of hard work on my end. Really, it's been a team effort, starting from Michelle as the president, and now the chancellor, you know, down through a number of different people contributing lots of hours and lots of time to having this come about. And we're really excited about it. I can't speak enough about the potential for new program, new student awareness, and lots of application for students to, again, learn how to have better lifestyles and make healthier lifestyle choices, and will open up lots of avenues for employment in the health industry once we're finished with it. It's an exciting situation.
You're watching Pierce TV, a production of the Digital Design Program at Pierce College.
Next up are some film shorts from our digital film program here at Pierce College.
All right, it's time to show. What do you got?
Royal flush. Five queens.
You know, this would probably be a lot funner if one of us wasn't cheating.
Hey guys, I've got a little bit of a problem.
What is it?
Well, I've kinda got myself into a duel.
A duel? Like in a game?
No, like with guns and to the death.
How the hell did you do that?
Well, hey, was that your girlfriend?
Yeah.
That has to be the ugliest person alive. Damn. I mean, damn.
I challenge you to a duel for the honor of my girlfriend.
Just can't go around slapping people. See how that feels?
Then you accept?
Well, if by accept you mean that your girlfriend has a body of a hippopotamus in the face of a monkey, then yes, I accept.
Tomorrow, 6:00. You better be there.
Dude, I don't even know. I thought I was being nice.
Alright, man. I think we can help you out with this.
Yeah, I know somebody who can help you.
Alright. What are you guys calling for?
Pat here got challenged to a duel tomorrow.
Well, let me inspect him. Just as I thought. He's as good as dead.
There's nothing you can do for him?
Well, I guess I could try. You, come with me. If you can shoot that bottle over there with this gun, you can shoot a person with a pistol. No, dude, that was just a little bit too much to the right. Move it over to the left, just a little bit. Kind of it. Alright, here. Let me show you how to do it. Ready? Yeah! That's how you...
Oh, dude! I'm so screwed.
Not just yet. I still have some tricks up my sleeve. Are you ready? Three. Two.
Wait! Think about what you're doing. Is this the way you want to be remembered? As a murderer? You can use words, not violence. If you could make the world a better place, would you? I would.
Nah. I think I'm happy killing you.
Well, I saw that one coming.
Yeah, I think we all did.
You guys! Where are you going? No one's gonna call an ambulance! Come on, guys! It's freezing out here!
Here from the Advising Center is Monica Nucciarone.
Pierce College offers a wide variety of distance learning courses. These courses can be conducted from the comfort of your own home, usually in an online format, but some are videotapes or CD-ROM. Most of our distance learning course offerings are geared towards our Associate of Arts degree. These classes fill up quick, so if you're interested in this type of learning format, register early. For details, refer to our quarterly bulletin for more information or log on to our website, www.pierce.ctc.edu/distance. But that's not all. There's another distance learning option that not many people are aware of. Through our military sites, Fort Lewis and McCord, Pierce College offers several distance learning courses in an online format that is open to everyone, including civilians. These courses are conducted as continuous entry, which means that you can register for these courses at any point in time, but you do have 10 weeks to complete them. It is highly recommended to order your textbooks online first, and once they arrive, then register for your online classes. For details, refer to the quarterly bulletin published by our military sites for more information, or log on to our website, www.pierce.ctc.edu/military.
It's basketball season here at Pierce. Up next is an animated schedule for both the men's and the women's teams. Several of the games are broadcast live on KLAY Radio. Be sure to check out the athletics website to find out which ones.
Catch all the action and excitement of Pierce College Raiders basketball live at the Lakewood Community Center. Cheer on the Raider men and women as they play some of the toughest teams in the Pacific Northwest right here for the hometown crowd. Call or check online for game information and follow the Raiders on KLAY Radio, 1180 AM. Pierce College and Raiders basketball, from where you are to where you want to be.
Thanks for watching. We'll be back in February with another episode.
If you want to catch this episode again, it will be available on the web at pierce.ctc.edu/pierceTV.